Hi, this is AJ Locascio, the voice of Marty McFly in Telltale's Back to the Future game. I'm here at Gallery 1988 in Santa Monica, and we're here to check out the 3B exhibit, Beetlejuice, Back to the Future, and Bill and Ted. And I'm here for obvious reasons. Let's go check it out. I'm here with Jensen, co-owner of Gallery 1988, and tell me, why did you put this show on?
Well, actually, we did this last year with a show called 3G, which was three movies that started with the letter G, which coincidentally was Gremlins, Ghostbusters, and Goonies. And we wanted to have sort of a sequel to the 3G show, and we went through letters and movies that we love, and B was a common theme amongst three other movies that we loved. So, and there was Big, and there were other ones that we had sort of that ended up on the cutting room floor that we loved too. But these are obviously three movies that have a lot of nostalgia and sort of are commonly loved by so many different people in our generation.
Did you get a lot of people that would not normally come to a gallery coming to a show like this?
Yeah, our gallery, we kind of cater to the first-time buyer, you know what I mean? Like, we open the gallery to sort of make fun of stuffy, adult-themed art galleries in the idea that a lot of our friends were spending, you know, like $400 on sneakers or $500 on a purse, but $10 on, like, a Scarface poster or, like, a baby in a banana suit. And we just thought there was sort of a middle ground, and pop culture sort of is the perfect thing to speak to a lot of people who might not have the money to buy, you know, an original huge painting for their wall, but they are huge fans of Bill and Ted's or Back to the Future and can spend $30 to $300 on a piece.
I'm here with Casey, one of the artists. Where are you from, Casey?
New Jersey.
You came all the way from New Jersey for this. Wow. So what inspired you to do Back to the Future art? What inspired the specific pieces you chose?
I chose Back to the Future 2 for mine because my pieces are three-dimensional, so they're like layered. So I thought that the Jaws scene from the second one would be a good one since it's a hologram coming out from the building, so I thought it would look cool in 3D.
I'm here with one of the fans, and tell us, what brought you here?
I would definitely say all the Back to the Future art, as well as Beetlejuice and Bill and Ted, but definitely Back to the Future.
Are you planning on buying anything, especially Back to the Future related, of course?
Oh, yeah, some of the pieces here definitely aroused my interest, I would say, especially some of the Back to the Future pieces, for sure. I mean, there's scenes I'm seeing up on the walls here that I almost don't remember from the Back to the Future movies, but it's kind of interesting seeing different artists' takes on everything, and it's the different styles and different representations from one of my favorite movies.
I'm here with the artist responsible for this amazing piece, and I have to say, Jennifer has never looked so good. What inspired this?
I'm going to say the first Jennifer. Nothing against Elizabeth Shue, because she, you know, she's a hottie too, but the first one really stands out a lot more to me. But what we got going on here is basically all the things from part 1, 2, and 3. I didn't want to leave anything out. The way I look at it, it's Marty's room. He had to take off, do some time traveling. But then we got just kind of some crap that he got left around. He has the sports almanac, the hoverboard, the picture they got from Doc, the Huey Lewis poster up on the walls, and of course, you know, the purple Calvin Klein. So.
Well, in this reporter's humble opinion, this gallery is a hit. Come to Gallery 1988 in Santa Monica. Check out the 3B exhibit. This is AJ Locascio from BTTF.com. I'll see you guys in the future.